Hey guys, welcome to SRE 101. For the last few weeks, I have been working on an open source project that I call Dockershrink. It is essentially an AI assistant that helps you reduce the size of your Docker images by cleverly optimizing the code in your Docker file. Dockershrink automatically applies techniques like multi-stage builds, combined with lightweight base images, checking for unused dependencies, and many other tricks which are often specific to your tech stack and the nature of your application. In a previous video, I explained all these strategies in more detail, so feel free to refer to it. I've included all necessary links in the description. Behind the curtain, Dockershrink uses OpenAI's GPT-4o with a lot of custom prompting, access to knowledge, and code analysis. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to install Dockershrink and how I reduce the size of my 2GB Docker image down by 60%. Currently, Dockershrink only supports Node.js projects, but I do plan on adding support for Python and Go in the coming months. So let's get started. Now, installation process is very simple. If you're using Mac or Linux and you have Homebrew, just use the brew install command and you can install Dockershrink very easily. Otherwise, you can head to the releases page of this repository and you can download a binary which is suitable for your platform. And if you're feeling adventurous, you can also just clone this repository and build the code yourself into binary. The instructions are here. Cool. Now, once you're done with the installation, head over to your terminal and try running the help command to see that the binary is working fine. This is what you should see as a help message. And okay, so as you can see, there are two main functionalities that Dockershrink provides. One is generate and one is optimize. I think the names are self-explanatory. So let's dive straight into optimization. So I created a sample in Node.js application. The main code is in server.js. And if I just run server.js, it starts a server. That's all we need to know about this application. We don't need to know about the nature right now. More importantly, we have the package.json, which defines, amongst many other things, the dependencies and the dev dependencies for this application. If you've worked with Node.js applications, you know that these are the things that add the most bloat. I also have currently a very basic Docker file over here, which is very simple. It uses a base Node.js image, creates a directory, copies the package.json, installs everything, which means it installs all the dependencies and dev dependencies, then copies the code and just runs the server.js, right? This is how we start building a Docker image. So first I want to build a Docker image out of this Docker file. What do I have at the moment? Nothing. Okay, good. So let's go ahead and build my app and call it original. Okay, good. Now at the moment, my app is 2.05, so let's say 2GB in size, right? To optimize my Docker image with Dockershrink, I just have to do two things. Number one, I should supply my OpenAI API key as an environment variable. And number two, call the Dockershrink optimize command. Something like this. You enter your key here. I am obviously not going to record my API key in this video. And once you're done with that, let's invoke Dockershrink with the optimize command. Oh, and one more thing, you can also supply the debug flag. It gives you detailed logs about how Dockershrink interacts with the underlying LLM. If there are any issues with the optimize command or the generate command, then this debug will actually help you figure out what those issues could be. For now, I'm gonna not use debug, just to show the output. Okay, I have some output. It looks like Dockershrink did something. First of all, there is currently no docker-ignore file in my project. Fine. Secondly, Dockershrink is notifying me that all the new assets have been saved to dockershrink.out directory. So nothing has been changed in the original project. It just adds a new directory inside the project, and that's where all the changed files are, right? Couple of actions were taken. a Dockerignore file was created and some entries were also added to the Dockerignore file, specifically node modules and all these. Dockerignore makes sure that certain files and folders don't go inside your Docker image, even when you're copying everything. When you have a simple command copy dot dot, which copies everything from your local build context, it will not copy the files and folders inside Dockerignore. Then comes the main thing, which is the changes it has made in the Docker file itself. So first, it seems to have adopted the multi-stage builds and used a lightweight base image, specifically Alpine, so that the final stage only contains what is necessary for the application to run, right? Secondly, Dockershrink has also made some changes to make sure dev dependencies from the package JSON do not get included in the final image. And lastly, there is a recommendation that you should run depth check to identify unused dependencies. Depth check is a tool which automatically checks your code base to figure out if there are any dependencies that are declared in your package JSON, but you are not actually using them in your application. So this is very helpful because you can get rid of such dependencies. They don't get installed as part of your node modules, therefore reducing the size of your Docker image further. So I know that this is the recommendation, so I will need to implement this myself because Dockershrink couldn't. But what has Dockershrink produced so far? This directory. So let's go inside this directory and let's see. I have a Dockerignore and I already know from the logs. Let's check the new Docker file. Yeah, so this is what the new Docker file now looks like. The original Docker file stage, node 23, was named as build. So Dockershrink is treating the original stage as just the build stage, where we set up some files, install, and don't do anything else right now. And I guess this is also the best place for me to run depth check, so that all this checkup happens within the build stage, and none of the extra stuff makes it to the final stage, which does not require depth check. For the final stage, it has used node 23 Alpine, and it has set the node env to production. When you set this environment variable to production, it has a side effect that all the npm install or yarn install commands will only install the production dependencies and they will exclude any dev dependencies, right? And to be double sure, it also included omit dev as a flag. So this ensures that we are only installing production dependencies. Finally, Dockershrink is only copying the files which it thinks are absolutely necessary for the application to run. And I think this is absolutely true because for my image to run, all I need is server.js and article CSV. And finally, I have the server.js run command. So I think this is actually a very well-written Docker file because I think this will significantly reduce the size. Let me also add depth check as recommended by Dockershrink. The best place to run depth check is right after you have copied all your files, including package JSON and all the code inside your Docker image. And we can use NPX for that. Cool. Let's try to build this Docker file now. Wait, I need to move those things. So I moved the assets created by Dockershrink into the main project and I removed the Dockershrink out directory. Now let's build. And I'm going to give it a different tag, dshrink, so that we can compare from the original. Let's build. As you can see, depth check is also running. Cool. The moment of truth. Boom, there. Now, the new application image, which has a tag of dshrink, is a total of 660 MB, down from the original 2 GB. And all of this happened automatically just because I invoked Dockershrink optimize. So just by using Dockershrink, I automatically applied the best practices in my Docker file and significantly reduced my image size. I think it's more than 60% actually. So this is how Dockershrink can significantly improve your image posture. Now, I'm not saying that it will 100% optimize your Docker image, but it can get you to 80% over there, right? Maybe the last 20% you still have to work through it, but a lot of it can be automated now. By the way, if I run the optimize command again over this project, I am not guaranteed to receive the exact same Docker file again. This is because of the nature of LLMs. Basically, if you ask ChatGPT the same question twice, you may get two different answers, formed in a different way, but the underlying meaning will probably be the same. Same idea here. This is the current limitation of Dockershrink, and I'm actively working on making the output more deterministic. What you can be sure of is that whatever code is produced by Dockershrink will definitely optimize your image and reduce the bloat. So, as you can see, the main goal of Dockershrink is to automatically write optimized Docker files which are specific to your application and its tech stack. Other than this, Dockershrink also allows you to generate a new Docker file for your project. This command tries to understand your app, its purpose, structure, startup commands, and then generates an image definition, again, with a focus on keeping the size as low as possible. I'm going to cover this generate command in more detail in a later video. If you guys are interested in seeing specific features in Dockershrink, reach out to me here in the comments or in our Slack channel. And let me know if you want to see a video covering the internals of this tool. I can go into the technical details of how I built it. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. Give Dockershrink a try. Leave a star on the GitHub repository. It means you support my work, and that means a lot to me. And I really hope this will save you lots of pain in your job. See you next time.